morning sun shines on the gleaming hide of a muscular ranch horse. The aroma of bacon and coffee drifts from the wood cook stove at a cow camp. Silver spurs jingle as the men and women of the West get set for another day in the saddle. From the heart of Canada's finest ranching country, this is the Spirit of the West with rancher and horse trainer Hugh McLennan and his collection of music, poetry, and conversations with the folks who live and work with horses and cattle in the Spirit of the West.
As the trail winds and wanders into early fall, it's time to get ready for the early gathers, with the yearlings and some red heifers being trailed down from the high country, and they seem to like it better up there where it's cool. And the horses are seasoned and sound, and that's from a long, hot summer of hard work, and the tinge of fall in the air sure feels good. This week, you'll hear some true cowboy adventures covering everything from rodeo broncs to capturing wild horses.
If a guy wants a bucking horse rider, he better not be around here. Well, some of them were 5, 6 years old, never had a rope on, just run on the range.
These stories are precious and priceless. Roger Baker spent his life in the rugged, timbered ranges of the BC interior. And yep, it was you catch him, you gotta ride him. On the Rangeland News, now this sounds like a new miracle cure, like the Fountain of Youth or something.
It helps to improve your cognitive health, meaning you can think more clearly, problem solve.
I can't wait to find out what that is. I hope they can bottle it and sell it. And on the Irvine Saddles and Western Wear horse training file, a listener has a horse that is a chronic cribber and wants to know if there's any cure for this behavior. In the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight, I will play a track from our brand new CD called A Little Past Our Prime. In fact, it is the only poetry track on the album. And we'll start out with one I just love to hear coming out of the dashboard of the pickup when I'm driving home with my great young mare Becca in the trailer after a day's riding at the Duluth Ranch.
Sun, you can wash away your tears.
That's a group called A Little Farther West. It's actually a musical duo consisting of Robert Maxwell Case on that big electric guitar, kind of reminiscent of Duane Eddy style. And he does the vocals, and his wife Susie is on the organ, and they're based out of Slick, Oklahoma. And I do love the different kind of approach that they take to the songs of the West. You know, every part of the West has its legendary men and women who blaze the trails that we ride on today, and the rugged BC interior has produced a lot of them. And Roger Baker was sure one of them.
Roger started hundreds of horses in his lifetime, and back then they had to get them rode as soon as possible. Herb Mateer, recently inducted into the BC Cowboy Hall of Fame, worked with him for a while, and Roger says some of those horses could buck pretty good.
Well, I don't know whether you knew him or not. Old Herb Mateer.
Yeah.
Him and I broke 25 head, and he said, if a guy wasn't a bucking horse rider, he'd better not be around here. Well, some of them were, five, 6 years old, never had a rope on them, just run on the range. Well, you broke what you caught.
Yeah. How would you start with ones like that?
Just tie up a hind foot on them and sack them out, halt to break them first, and sack them out and saddle them up and long line them, and then get on them and ride them. And old Herb used to give me hell. You ruined it. I used to, if one wanted to buck, I'd make it practice. Some of them wouldn't buck, but most of them would.
Would they keep it up, or would most of them give it up after a while?
Most of them would give it up.
Who was the better bronc rider, you or Herb?
Well, I guess I was. Well, Herb was getting up in years.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know how he was when he was younger. I did all right till my back went on me. I got hurt and burning.
What happened there?
Horse bucked across the arena and lit up on top of the fence and come over backwards on top of me.
Holy smoke.
Put my back out of joint and my neck out of joint. And
that was in a rodeo?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I got over that. Then the last year I rode bucking horses, my back went on me. Last rodeo was in northern Alberta. I won 5 rodeos in succession and then had to quit.
You ride barebacks and saddle broncs?
No, I just saddle broncs and wild horse race.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I rode one bareback and bucked off.
And you'll hear Roger talking about one of the best horses he ever rode when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Oh, the beautiful Caribbean. Famous for turquoise water, sailing, snorkeling, and hanging out on the beach with endless sunshine. That's where you could be enjoying the camaraderie of folks you'll have a lot in common with. The 2025 Spirit of the West cruise aboard the Majestic Princess, and you will see 8 of the Caribbean's most beautiful ports of call. Airfare is included. This is a 14-day Circle of Caribbean cruise. And for details, just call toll-free 1-800-530-0131. The 2025 cruise destination visits 9 fantastic ports of call, sailing round trip from Fort Lauderdale. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. Coming up is a fine new song from Montana singer and picker John Lowell about a couple of Mustangs that turned into famous racehorses. And with the hundreds of horses that Roger Baker rode, I wanted to know if there was one that he could say was the best of all.
That Thoroughbred mare I had, by guys, now she was a good horse, a cow horse. You could tie the lines on the saddle horn and just leave her, and nobody put anything past you. She'd either run sideways or jump sideways. Well, I sold her. I brought her to sale here in Kamloops, and I only got offered $800 for her. I just took her out of the sale ring, and a woman came along, and she says, "What do you want for that mare?" I said, $2,500. She says, "I'll take her." And I saw her 2 or 3 years after that in Williams Lake. And she said, I said, "How'd you do with the sorrel mare?" "Very well, in reining classes and showing. Mosey was a beautiful looking animal."
Wow. You captured a lot of wild horses that used to run up in that Dead Man Creek, Loon Lake country.
Yeah.
There must have been a bunch of them up there in the early days.
We figured there was 500 on the south side, less than 500 on the north side. And that Charlie McMillan, he's around here somewhere. I've seen it a couple of years ago. We caught 100 the one year. And then I don't think you knew him, Bobby Sisson. And I chased horses, and we caught 50 the one winter and 45 the next. One bunch of them went to Evans at Chilliwack. The kids' ponies, there was old studs.
Yeah. Holy
there was a few good, you very seldom ever got a real good one. There was a good-looking black two-year-old stud in the outfit. And he did somebody bought him, Ray Wells, I don't know if you knew him, him. And the kid kept offering him more money for him all the time. He finally sold him to him. And I guess these kids got racing out of those five corners in Chilliwack.
Oh, yeah.
He went through a plate glass window. They said it didn't hurt the horse much, but it cost a little.
Well, coming up, you're going to hear about some cowboy and legends and a huge job they had to do with more wild horses. And this is John Lowell's brand new album called Snow on the Wine Glass. This song tells a great story about a couple of Mustangs, and it's called Pride of the Trail.
Come all you cowpunchers and lend me your ear as you sit round the table drinking your beer. I will tell you a story, a rousing good tale of the two fastest Mustangs, the pride of the trail.
Blacker than midnight, the other like milk, and the hair of their manes was as fine as French silk. Swifter than lightning in a strong summer gale
were the two fastest Mustangs. Oh, how their hooves rang, the two fastest Mustangs, the pride of the trail. Well, the black, he belonged to my part, Randall J, and I had the white horse for my getaway. We raced every ringer, and we won without fail on the two fastest Mustangs, the pride of the trail.
Once in West Texas, across the state plain, Mescaleros attacked us in rugged terrain. Bullets were whizzing and we scattered like quail
on the two fastest Mustangs. Oh, how their hooves sang, the two fastest Mustangs, the pride of the trail. To the Cap Rock we galloped and we never looked back as the thunderheads rumbled and the wind swept our track. We reached Amarillo through the rain and the hail on the two fastest Mustangs, the pride of the trail.
To the Musselshell River we hastened to roam, where the prairie wolves wander and the grizzlies call home. North to Montana where the winter winds wail
on the two fastest Mustangs. Oh, how their hooves rang, the two fastest Mustangs, the pride of the trail. You know time waits for no man, so we both settled down, Randall J, to a ranch house and me into town. Each double harness to a maid's bridal veil, and we pastured our Mustangs, the pride of the trail.
Now the years they wear on and the weather turns cold, and horses like men can but only grow old. Though age has us hobbled, in our hearts we prevail
on the two fastest Mustangs. Oh, how their hooves sang, the two fastest Mustangs, the pride of the trail. On the two fastest Mustangs, oh, how their hooves rang, the two fastest Mustangs, the pride of the trail.
Thank you.
was a huge challenge, and it took a top-notch crew of some of the interior's best rough country cowboys to get it done. A huge bunch of cows, badly infected with lice.
I tried to talk him into fixing up the stackyard, but he wouldn't. So we have to rope all these. There's over 400 head of them. Have to rope all these things. We had, there was Archie Williams and his brother and I. And we had three guys running around with louse powder.
On what?
I'll tell you, it was good practice for roping. And we had to rope them all again in about 2 weeks' time and do them over again.
Holy cow. Yeah, I can see how the first half dozen would be kind of fun, but after that it would get to be work.
But it just taught you to rope, I'll tell you.
Yeah. I've done
really bad at roping wild horses than I have cattle.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I can imagine, you know, when you, I've roped a few horses, none that were real, real wild, but I've had a few of them turn pretty wild as soon as I had them roped.
Oh, yeah. Some of them old ones.
Coming up, more great music and the Rangeland news when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. We're going to take a little ride across some parts of the West now, highlighting a couple of pretty neat places. As I've said from time to time, my wife Billy's dad, who would be my father-in-law, was born in the state of Nebraska. And Billy went back there for a visit when she was 6 years old. Her mom, her dad, two brothers, and two sisters traveled from the farm by Pinoca down through the states to California, over to Nebraska, and then back home in a 1949 Hillman Minx pulling a homemade plywood house trailer. Her dad sold to Hillman just as soon as they got home, and the great musician Joe Babcock still lives in Nebraska.
Get up, Joe, it's 5 o'clock and another day. Get yourself some breakfast and then be on your way. Yesterday was clear and dry, now the hay is on the ground. Rain is due tomorrow with 100 acres down. Get up on that stack now and spread it all around. Gotta build it good for when the rain comes down. It's gotta shed the water, can't let that hay go bad. 200 head of cattle in the winter to be fed. Oh, it's haying time in Nebraska, we work from sun to sun. Stars will be shining bright by the time that we get done. Oh, the sky's bright and clear and a hot sun shining down. It's haying time in Nebraska and the hay is on the ground. Oh, another load is coming in, here it comes, watch out. You dump it right on top of me, have to fight my way back out. We'll work right into supper time, by then the sun is down. Just can't stop for nothing when the hay is on the ground. At 4 o'clock we'll stop a while, wipe away the dirt. Sister brings some tea and cake and then it's back to work. We'll work until it's supper time, by then the sun is down. Just can't stop for nothing when the hay is on the ground. It's haying time in Nebraska, we work from sun to sun. The stars will be shining bright by the time that we get done. Oh, the sky's bright and clear and a hot sun shining down. It's haying time in Nebraska and the hay is on the ground. It's haying time in Nebraska, the hay is on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
If you're buying or selling farm machinery, heavy equipment, or trucks, let Progressive Auctions take the hassle out of your sale or your search. There's an online auction every Wednesday at progressiveauctions.ca. Doesn't matter where you live, Progressive Auctions can find the machinery or equipment you need or the buyers who are looking for what you're selling. ProgressiveAuctions.ca. For more information, call 844-309-9424.
The Rangeland News from the Spirit of the West. A roundup of issues and events from the world of agriculture.
At the top of page one, it says, "Sometimes I almost think I can see it sneaking up behind me. That old outlaw time, and he's got his eyes set on my reflexes, my flexibility, and I forgot the other one. Oh yeah, my memory. And hey, Gary Crawford, is this really happening?"
It's true. As we age, our brain's ability to process and think is diminished over time.
But there are a lot of things we can do to delay that as long as possible.
Kansas State University professor Sherilyn Jackson says one of those ways to help the brain is to move the body. She says it
helps improve the blood flow to the brain. That's really a key thing. It helps reduce inflammation. It helps to improve your cognitive health, meaning you can think more clearly, problem solve.
Physical activity also reduces the production of stress hormones, increases release of those feel-good hormones, and so as a result,
it helps us sleep better. That again plays into cognitive health.
Jackson says you don't have to have a rigorous exercise regime to get the benefits, but just simply
getting movement throughout your day.
Jackson says just getting up out of the chair and walking around the room every half hour or so can work wonders for the brain. Gary Crawford for the U.S. Department of Agriculture.
Okay, so there we have it. But a lot of ranchers and farmers and cowboys I know move around quite a lot through the day. Well, forage conditions have improved for Texas cattle ranchers, but rebuilding the statewide herd has been slow. According to Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service experts, Jason Clear, an extension specialist in the Texas A&M Department of Animal Science, said soil moisture, grazing conditions, and hay supplies improved this year, and optimism is up a bit among cattle producers in a lot of the state, but so far, Texas ranchers have not been holding back heifers or buying replacement heifers and young bred cows at rates that indicate any growth. The size of Texas's herd ripples into the supply side of the national beef cattle markets, from sale barns to grocery stores to meat counters, and the state carries around 14.6% of the nation's beef cattle. There's a lot of optimism based on calf prices, the moisture a lot of the state has gotten, and the potential for moisture going into fall, Clear said, but in the grand scheme of things, our market outlook experts are saying we haven't started rebuilding yet. In June of this year, Canadian farmers experienced fluctuating prices for a range of farm products, including grain, oilseed, specialty crops, and livestock, according to Statistics Canada. These changes reflect the complex dynamics of domestic and international agricultural markets. Durum wheat prices in Saskatchewan and Alberta continue to drop for the ninth consecutive month, declining 4% and 2.4% respectively. And this ongoing decrease, influenced by competitive export markets, also marked the year-over-year price fall of at least 5.9% in these provinces. Canola prices varied across the prairies. Manitoba and Saskatchewan witnessed declines of 1.6% and 1.2% due to reduced domestic crushing activities. And in contrast, Alberta saw a slight increase of 0.6%. But overall, year-over-year prices were down over 12.5%, stabilizing from the record highs of June 2022. And the livestock sector showed a positive trend in finished cattle prices, with rises in all provinces except Ontario that saw a 4% decrease. Quebec led the increases with a rise of 6.6%. A team of food scientists at West Pomeranian University of Technology in Poland has found that using mare's milk instead of cow's milk to make ice cream is a viable food choice. In their study, published in the open access site Plozone, the group created four ice cream varieties using mare's milk and different types of bacteria. Traditionally, ice cream is made by adding cow's milk to cow's cream along with other ingredients. Yeah, we used to make it with the old hand crank with the dry ice and the cream. Anyway, the result is a sweet treat popular around the globe, and in this new study, the team found that replacing the cow's milk with milk from a mare and then adding it to cow's cream is a viable food source. Consumption of horse milk isn't unheard of. A lot of cultures around the world have used it instead of cow's milk for centuries. Many of them believe that it has yet to be proven health benefits, and prior research has shown that it is closer in makeup to human milk than cow's milk is, and that people with allergies to cow's milk can safely drink mare's milk. And speaking of milk, the Milk River Watershed Council of Canada is working with cows and fish and local landowners on the Little Fish Big Stewardship Project, and funding is being provided in part by Fisheries and Oceans of Canada through the Canada Nature Fund for Aquatic Species at Risk. The project aims to improve the riparian and in-stream habitat for fish at risk species in the Milk River watershed, and this will be accomplished by supporting local landowners to implement beneficial management. Get all the information at cowsandfish.org. September the 10th, there's a Kamloops yearling and regular sale at the Kamloops Yards of the BC Livestock Co-op. And then on September 12th, the Williams Lake regular sale, and September 13th, the Vanderhoof regular sale. And you can get all the information, watch the sale streaming live at bclivestock.bc.ca. And as the fall run rolls along, a lot of yearlings are coming to market, and if you're looking for a place to market them, or buy them, or sell or buy calves, try the Innisfail Auction Market. Regular cattle sales, of course, every Wednesday, and a lot of special sales coming up. Get all the information at InnisfailAuctionMarket.com. And now, here comes the final item.
I was browsing through the classified ad section of one of our well-known farm papers the other day, and you won't believe the stuff people are trying to sell. Listen to some of these examples. For sale, an antique desk suitable for a lady with thick legs and large drawers. Four-poster bed, 101 years old, perfect for antique lover. Or do they mean antique lover? Now's your chance to have your ears pierced and get an extra pair to take home, too. What? We do not tear your clothing with machinery. We do it all carefully by hand. That was from a laundry. Have several very old dresses from grandmother in beautiful condition. Here's another one. Dog for sale. Eats anything and is especially fond of children. Or this one. This motel offers a fantastic view. Relax in our pool and drink it all in. And here's another one. Stock up and save. Limit one to a customer. Or wanted. Man to take care of a cow that does not smoke or drink. Or this one. Auto repair service. Free pickup and delivery. Try us once. You'll never go anywhere again. All right, I like this one. Mixing bowl set designed to please a cook with round bottom for efficient beating. Or this one. We will oil your sewing machine and adjust tension in your home for only $20. And that's the Rangeland News.
You can forget all about pulling and searching all over the place to locate tractor parts. Check out the most convenient place to find parts for any make, bztractorparts.com. Massey Ferguson, Ford, John Deere, David Brown, Case, International Harvester, Universal, Deutz, Lightland, Landini, Oliver Flat, Ali, Zetor, White, and so many more. Just call 250-395-0960. Email bctractorparts56@gmail.com. This section started with a song about Nebraska. Now it's all the way back to Saskatchewan with Colter Wald and the Cypress Hill.
See the bear paws, the old man on his back. Prickly pears blooming in the short and late grass. There's a bunch of empty beer cans and an old loose mineral sack. Give you some idea where you're at. Buck brush and sage, far as you can see. It's the south slopes of the hills and turns to pines and poplar trees. Cattle all grazing up and down Big Coulee under Charlie Russell skies like a blue and purple sea. Cypress Hills and the big country below where life is still and a man can be alone. You can duck underneath all your trials and troubles for a time, like a pronghorn underneath the bottom wire. Cypress Hills and the big country below where life is still and a man can be alone. You can duck underneath all your trials and troubles for a time, like a pronghorn underneath the bottom wire. You can sweat and cuss and wonder why they say our West has died. Folks around the Cypress Hills still drag calves to the fire.
Nice picking there, Colter, and I love that line. The folks in the Cypress Hills still drag calves to the fire. The Irvine Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File looks at the habit of cribbing and if there's anything to stop a horse from doing it when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. More stories from Roger Baker coming up, along with more great music of the West, and the Irvine Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File is next. Oh, the beautiful Caribbean, famous for turquoise water, sailing, snorkeling, and hanging out on the beach with endless sunshine. That's where you could be enjoying the camaraderie of folks you'll have a lot in common with. The 2025 Spirit of the West cruise aboard the Majestic Princess, and you will see 8 of the Caribbean's most beautiful ports of call. Airfare is included. This is a 14-day Circle of Caribbean cruise, and for details, just call toll-free 1-800-530-0131. The 2025 cruise destination visits 9 fantastic ports of call, sailing round trip from Fort Lauderdale.
Now it's time for the Horse Training File, brought to you by Irvine Tack and Western Wear, Canada's largest Western store.
Whether you're in the pasture or the oil patch, you work hard, and you need quality workwear that's up to the challenge. Look no further than Irvine Tack and Western Wear. They've got it all to keep you warm and safe, including fire-resistant and high-visibility clothing featuring the biggest names in workwear from Ariat, Burn, Wrangler, and Snickers. Stop in or shop online at irvines.ca, exit 305 off Highway 2 by Crossfield.
The world's greatest Western store.
And this one came in on our Rangeland News bulletin board. It says, "Dear Hugh, we're hoping you might give us some advice or insight regarding a horse my dad owns who has trouble with the habit of cribbing. We've tried a lot of things like the cribbing strap, which doesn't seem to help. He lives out on a quarter section plus and still stands beside the fence post trying to crib. Even with a crib strap, he still goes through the motions. Standing tied to the hitching rail, he is awful." Well, here's my answer. Cribbing is a tough problem. A horse becomes addicted to the act of clamping his teeth onto something solid and gulping air until his diaphragm is full. And I've seen a lot of cribbers, and nothing I know of has worked very well in overcoming it. Horses on pasture usually do all right in the summer, but in the winter when they're on dry feed, they almost always lose a lot of weight because, you see, their stomach is constantly full of air, and they don't take in enough nutrition. And sometimes non-cribbers can pick the habit up just from watching a cribber. And it seems as addictive as a person with a chronic nail-biting problem or something like that. A lot of horses will chew on boards or wood fences, especially in the winter, but that doesn't mean they're cribbers. It's when they develop the habit of gulping air that the problem is serious. The old-timers sometimes use the term windsuckers to describe them. But as far as I know, there's no known permanent cure. And that's this week's Horse Training File.
Brought to you by Irvine Saddles and Western Wear. And we always try to take the best care we can of our horses. Some of them are getting up in years, and the younger ones work pretty hard. And they all get a daily feeding of Hoffman's Horse Ration. Highly recommend it. Find out all about it at hoffmanshorseproducts.com. One of the famous people, I guess you could say, that I've ridden quite a few miles with over the years is Gary Felgard, multi-award-winning member of the Canadian Country Music Hall of Fame, and much more. Always a great picker. His playing is superb, as is his singing on a song he wrote called Heartbreak Trail.
Tracks in the dust on the heartbreak trail. My collar up, riding all alone. The night wind seemed to cry on the heartbreak trail. But this old cowboy's coming home. There was a big old yellow moon on the heartbreak trail. I remember the reflection in her eyes. The tears fell like rain on the heartbreak trail. The night that this old cowboy said goodbye. We could be the heroes in a movie of the week about a cowboy and his foolish pride, and a riding in the sunset, happy ending. My pony seems so eager, he holds his head up high. The moon goes down, another day begins. Just a few more miles to water and two arms to hold me tight, and I'll never ride that heartbreak trail again. Could be the heroes in a movie of the week about a cowboy and his foolish pride, and a riding in the sunset, happy ending. But just a few more miles to water and two arms to hold me tight, and I'll never ride that heartbreak trail again. No, I'll never ride that heartbreak trail again.
You know, the idea of capturing wild horses has fired our imaginations for years. I've been lucky enough to visit with a lot of men and women who made part or all of their living doing this, and Roger Baker has caught a lot of wild horses. Roger, I would think that a good, grain-fed, well-conditioned saddle horse should be able to wear down a wild horse if you kept at it.
Last one I caught, I wore down. He was in damn good shape, too. I imagine you know him, what you call him, Jerry Spooner was with.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I know Jerry.
Well, Jerry never chased any horses. And the snow was fairly deep, and they just followed. staying behind this horse. And Jerry says, what are we going to do? I said, we'll eventually catch him. He'll get tired. Run him out to the towards the Didman's Creek Reserve, and there was a fence there, and there was an open on the hill. I said, Jerry, you sit on that open. I'll bring that horse up. And Jerry roped him when he came up. Then we had a hell of a time loading him.
Yeah. What, you just have a truck to try and get him into?
Yeah, and a bank.
Oh, yeah. I don't imagine he was too well haltered roped.
We hog-tied him. Yeah. And there was a guy that was logging up there that I knew, a great big son of a gun. We were trying to shove this horse in the back of the truck. And hell, he says, I can put him in there. And he just drug him in.
I want to call him sir.
Yeah, I think so.
Still to come this week's classic Song of the West and the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. A beautiful classic Song of the West is coming up, but, you know, a brand new CD just came in the mail today, and it's called Singin' to the Cows from Chris Guthrie. It's a powerful contemporary collection of Western music, and this one takes us back to an awful tough winter. It's called Long and Bitter Chill.
It was a blizzard of 97, a time I remember when. Fierce winds of snow around us, a cold and violent hell. The storm blew across the shelter where the cattle hunkered down. I drove them out to pasture 4 miles across the ground. I still see that April morning when I look upon those fields. The cows and calves were frozen. Surreal. From the fence line to the ditches, 100 bodies lying still. The silence wide and empty, a long and bitter chill.
Happier note now, Riders in the Sky, still going strong, appearing regularly in the Grand Ole Opry, and they do a fine job on this classic from the mighty pen of Bob Nolan. I love the sound of Joey Miskelen's accordion on Lord, You Made the Cowboy Happy.
I met a cowboy on the train just the other day. I still can hear his howdy boy as he up and rode away. He turned in the saddle, he raised his hand, this carefree sort of a lad. His smile was sent from heaven above, and heaven made him glad. The white clouds sailed before the wind, the grass bows to the touch of him. The hills are where they've always been.
Lord, you made the cowboy happy.
The plains are big and grand as you. The sun is always shining through. My heart is always smiling too.
Lord, you made the cowboy happy.
I know that someday, somewhere, this trail must surely end. I know that when I get there, this message I will send.
You gave this happy heart to me, these eyes that beauty I might see.
Then like the wind you set me free.
Lord, you made the cowboy happy.
I know that someday, somewhere, this trail must surely end. I know that when I get there, this message I will send.
You gave this happy heart to me, these eyes that beauty I might see.
Then like the wind you set me free.
Lord, you made the cowboy happy. Lord, you set the cowboy free.
The new album from the Western Spirit Band is now out, and you can find out more about it at our website, hugh-mclennan.com, and it's called, appropriately, I guess, A Little Past Our Prime. We included one piece of poetry along with the music, and my friend Daryl Arnold wrote these words, and they've always moved me when I listened to them, and I always wanted to record them. The background is little brother Jim playing his song, Gladys Ridge. On the west side of the Rockies, where the Selkirk Mountains stand, roamed an old unbranded stallion and his freedom-loving band. Feral horses had been grazing there for nearly 100 years, descendants of the livestock that escaped the pioneers. Though they numbered only 20 then, they once in hundreds ran before the herds were gathered for the saddle and the can. But the old unbranded stallion, never captured and always free, was a source of song and legend and a taunting mystery. At times, he'd roam the ranges and he'd steal a rancher's mares, and they'd try and rope and trap him, but he always slipped their snares. At night, his spectral figure neath the moon's abundant light made the superstitious shiver at his image ghostly white. Now, in those mountains lived a rancher who was proud and bold and strong, and he swore this devil stallion had been running free for too long. So he gathered all his cowboys and he bade them all to ride and not return until they'd caught that horse called Devil's Pride. Now the mountain trails were wild and steep, but the Mustangs knew the way, and the cowboys rode and tracked and searched, and they followed for so many days till one by one the mares and foals were roped and caught, but one remained out there, the stallion Devil's Pride, still free,
and on the run. The cowboys dogged his every move. They watched from rocky knolls, they rode the ridges, they combed the draws, and they even blocked the water holes. They tried to wear the stallion down, they never let him rest. But the rancher wanted Devil caught, so on and on they pressed. But Devil's pride would not give in. He loved his freedom so. And the weary cowboys asked themselves, how much further could he go? One day they had him cornered, blocked in where the walls were high. But the stallion bared his teeth and charged, and the cowboys had to let him by. Ah, caballo mucho, someone said, and the others nodded true. This horse they were chasing was special, and for him their fondness grew. Still on and on they rode. To catch him was their aim, and the man that roped old Devil's pride would wear a hero's name. And then one day, at a place called Eagle Point, the cowboys found their prey. They had him trapped at last, and it looked like this was gonna be the day. The stallion turned again to run, but there was no place left to go, and the rimrock cliffs in front of him dropped 1,000 feet below. So he turned again to the attack, and he charged the cowboy line. And that's when he felt at once the roper's twisted twine. The roper yelled he'd caught the stud. This was the victor's prize. But a moment later, stark terror filled his eyes. For Devil's pride, the great white horse could not his freedom give. Within him burned a spirit that could not, as a captive, live. The stallion reared and pawed and kicked and tossed his head goodbye. And he ran and jumped from Eagle Point to fly and fall and die. The roper screamed and dropped his dallies, and the sizzling rope came free, and how close to death that cowboy came was plain for all to see. And on the rock so far below lay the form of Devil's pride. The saddened cowboys doffed their hats, whispered prayers, and cried. And then turned to head for home, because their mighty quest was done. No more would mares be stolen from this stallion on the run. And yet somehow it was clear the horse had won, because it was plain for all to see that Devil's pride would always remain unbranded, wild, and free. Thanks again for making the ride, and I sure hope you can join us right here next week at the same time. And as always, thanks to Mark and Kathy McMillan, our great support crew. Now, be sure to check the latest issue of Canadian Cowboy Country Magazine for all kinds of great reading and pictures, and you can subscribe online at canadiancowboy.ca. Be sure to check out our YouTube channel for this show and many more from the past, with video and lots of videos of the Western Spirit Band and ranching scenes and much more. The links are on our website, hugh-mclennan.com. Till next week, I'm Hugh McLennan. Hope to see you down the trail somewhere real soon.